Hello, I'm Dr. Akash Prabhu, consultant neurosurgeon and endoscopic brain and spine surgeon at WIINS Hospital, Kolhapur. Today, I'm here to talk about brain tumors. So, first of all, what are brain tumors? A tumor is an abnormal growth in any part of the body. So, if it happens in the brain, it is an abnormal growth of cells in the brain. Now, how does brain tumor happen? Usually, the cells in our body have an autoregulation mechanism where after growing to a certain size, they have certain signals sent to them that stop the growth. But in case of brain tumors, this signal to stop gets lost and the cells keep growing continuously. What are the types of brain tumors? The brain tumors can be broadly divided into two types: benign tumors and cancerous tumors, malignant tumors. Benign tumors basically mean abnormal growth of cells in the brain, which is not cancer. These usually have a better prognosis. If we operate and take out this tumor, it usually does not cause more problems and does not come back again. Malignant tumors, on the other hand, keep increasing and spread via microscopic paths. So even after removal, they sometimes need other therapies like chemotherapy and radiotherapy to stop their growth completely. Why does a brain tumor happen? Now, the exact cause as to why most brain tumors happen is still not known. But there are a few risk factors that have been identified which could potentially cause a brain tumor. Some of them being genetic mutations or family history of brain tumors, exposure to radiation, to a high amount of radiation, then a weak immune system can lead to these cells growing abnormally, and long-term exposure to certain chemicals which are called carcinogens also can lead to tumors in the body, including brain tumors. Now, what are the symptoms of a brain tumor? The symptoms of a brain tumor depend on which part of the brain that they grow in. That a brain tumor whispers, it does not scream, which means that the symptoms of brain tumors will be very subtle and may not immediately make you think of something as serious as a brain tumor. It can be headaches, persistent headaches, then it can be vomiting, it can be problems in vision, imbalance and behavioral changes. Many a times, a simple problem like a headache is faced by almost all the population and we tend to ignore it. But when does a headache become significant? If it is continuous, if it is increasing as time passes, if it is more in the morning times, and if it is accompanied by vomiting, which usually leads to relief of the headache. This is a headache that needs to be investigated. You need to go to your health provider and get the necessary examination and tests done. Other symptoms of brain tumors will include seizures or fits in which a patient can become unconscious and can have rhythmic movements of the hands and feet, and difficulty in speaking or understanding words spoken by others. Memory disturbances can also be leading to a symptom of brain tumor. How do we detect a brain tumor? First of all, a brain tumor is not a very common diagnosis. So not every headache is a brain tumor. In case a headache is persistent or worrisome, you need to meet your doctor and get it checked. And they will ask for certain tests to determine whether it is a headache to worry about or not. Now, how do we detect brain tumors? Usually, the doctor will do a clinical examination. They will do certain tests on you and see if there are any inclinations towards a problem in the brain. Then we may ask for a CT scan of the brain, which shows us a rough image of the brain. A MRI of the brain is what we call a gold standard in diagnosing brain tumors. It is non-invasive, it is harmless, it does not have any radiations, and it gives us a very clear picture of the brain and the structures within it, which can help us determine if there are any problems or brain tumors within. In some cases, there might be a doubt after the MRI scan, and in case there is a growth there, we may do something called a biopsy or a stereotactic biopsy, where a small hole is made in your brain, in your skull, and a tiny piece of that tissue is taken for examination. This is usually done when the patient is awake, but you will not remember the procedure at the end of it. So you do not need to worry about how you will be feeling throughout the procedure. In case there is a lesion in your brain, the gold standard or the best way to confirm is via a biopsy. Now, one question that I get asked very commonly is a brain tumor curable? Now, the answer depends on what type of tumor it is. If it is a benign tumor, which more than 50% of the tumors are, then they usually have a good prognosis. With surgery at a good center and a complete removal, you can usually have a disease-free life after that. Even certain malignant tumors after surgical removal and chemo and radiotherapy give a very good quality of life, and some observation is needed as to whether they are growing or not. Now, I also get asked very often how to prevent brain tumors. Now, there is no direct cause known. So what we can do is make certain lifestyle changes and live healthy and avoid certain carcinogens to avoid not only brain tumors but any other cancer in the body. Maintain a healthy and active lifestyle, get enough sleep, live stress-free, avoid consuming processed foods with harmful chemicals, avoid carcinogens, and definitely avoid smoking. If in case anybody in your family has had a history of tumors, you need to get evaluated regularly to make sure that it is not a genetic condition causing these brain tumors. Now, in conclusion, brain tumors don't scream, they whisper. The signs are often subtle and often ignored by people. So in case you have any of the above symptoms which are persistent, I encourage you to contact your healthcare provider and get evaluated to make a timely or early diagnosis and even prevent it in many cases. In case you have any further questions or queries, you can comment below and we will get back to you with the answers that you need. Thank you.